exhilarating sports talk coming up next on The Doug Stewart Show in about 2 minutes. Stay tuned. We're about to have some fun. That's right. Sports talk, guy talk, right here on The Doug Stewart Show. Show coming up in about a minute and a half. Hold on. To no puppet zone. That's right, no puppetry around here. The Doug Stewart Show coming up in about 1 minute. The realest, treeless, most unfiltered sports and guy talk show in America. The Doug Stewart Show, coming up in about 30 seconds. Yes!
Play this record as frequently as possible.
The Doug Stewart Show
is the best in the world as far as I'm concerned.
This is sports talk for the people. The Doug Stewart Show. It's like the tail wagging the dog. They create the narrative. Don't believe it. Don't fall for the banana in the tailpipe. Or are you not entertained?
This is sports talk with hot sauce.
Texas Pete hot sauce. The Doug Stewart Show.
Yeah!
It's a Wild Out Wednesday, and oh boy, we got a lot of great things planned for you today, as we do every single day. Thank you for joining your boy. Good morning to the Stewies. Good morning. Oh man, we're going to have some fun today, man. But before we even get to that fun, Cassidy, bring that beat back for your boy one more time. Bring it back. Yes, sir. Scratch beat. This is the Doug Stewart Show. Wild Out Wednesday, March 30th, 2016. And it's going to be interesting today, man. The whole man laws rears its ugly head again. Man laws rears its ugly head once again. We had an entire show on man laws very early in the Doug Stewart Show back in 2014. That was probably one of the more fun shows that we've ever done. The whole concept and the thought of man laws, and man laws has reared its ugly head once again. We're going to get into that. You see the title of today's show. It's a R.A.P. for D'Angelo Russell. Now, listen, let me just say this right now, because I said this last week and somebody made mention of it in the chat room. The whole R.A.P. thing is kind of like an inside joke for the Two Live Stews and its listeners, because my brother Ryan say, you know, whenever you're talking about it, it's a wrap, you know, something's over, something's done. you know, obviously it's actually WRAP. But for some reason, my brother always just said RAP. And I don't know whether it's the hitch to the head or whatever. So the RAP is a Two Live Stews type of kind of like inside joke thing. Hey, thank you so much for joining your boy on the Doug Stewart Show. This is a Wild Out Wednesday once again. Good morning to the Stewies. The Doug Stewart Show is brought to you by ID Life. What is ID Life? ID Life is individualized nutrition. ID Life is the future of health and wellness. ID Life is the Netflix of nutrition. What it is, man, you go to ID Life or the DougStewartShow.IDLife.com. You can take a free assessment on your health. Based on the answers that you give, ID Life will build, in effect, develop supplements specifically for you based on the answers that you give. All right, it's a novel idea. It's a great idea. I don't know what took everybody so long to figure this out. Maybe we just have the technology to make it happen now. But go to the DougStewartShow.IDLife.com. Take your free assessment once again and get healthy and get healthier in 2016, all right? All right, today, man, we packed for you today. Today on the Doug Stewart Show, obviously we're going to talk about this D'Angelo Russell story, which is the number one trending story in the world right now. We'll talk about that. The Golden State Warriors handle their business. The latest on Bones Jones' traffic stop. And Lil Wayne signs who? We'll talk about that. Falcons linebacker, man, is in the news. We'll talk about that. And the Atlanta Hawks clinch. But today as well on the Stewart Media and Entertainment Network, we've got the Kicking It with Kesey show coming up at 12 p.m. noon Eastern time. My man Kesey talks to Jamie Bennett from Fortune 500 to entrepreneur in all aspects of success. So if you're an entrepreneur, if you're somebody out there trying to get it, you need to tune into the Kicking It with Kesey show today at 12 p.m. Eastern time. You do have to log back in. Make sure, and let me back up as a matter of fact. That's a good point to tell you this. If you're new to the Doug Stewart Show, what you need to do, a couple things you need to do is go to Spreaker.com, find the Doug Stewart Show. Just search the Doug Stewart Show. It'll pop up. Once you find it, hit the follow button. So the follow button allows you to receive alerts whenever the show, this show or any other show on the network goes live. So make sure you do that. And then you need to jump in the chat room as well while you're there for the Doug Stewart Show. We have the best chat room in America. I call it the Fantasy Island of Sports and Guy Chat. Its inhabitants, I think I already called their name already this morning. Its inhabitants, I call those people the Stewies. Yes! Yeah. So today, a lot of times we air the other shows on the network on my stream, but today we're going to let my man Kesey fly solo. So at 12 p.m. Eastern time, about 5 minutes after my show is done, tune in to Stewart Media and Entertainment and check out the Kicking It with Kesey show. It's got a great show for you entrepreneurs. And then at 1 p.m. today, the return of my man Poe Politikin. This is going to be interesting today. This is going to be very interesting today. So the Poe Politikin show comes on at 1 p.m. Eastern time right here on SME. And Poe talks to Mitchie Slick. He's a San Diego rap veteran. And he was actually featured in the TV show Gangland and talking about the Linkin Park Bloods, who he has an association with. That's the way they term it. So very interesting guy, man. Rapper, big time. Rapper, I guess, on the West Coast of San Diego. Once again, tune in today at 1 p.m. and check out that interview. My man Poe from the Poe Politikin shows does the best interviews around, man. So tune in at 1 p.m. Eastern today right here on SME. I love that Gangland. I don't know why I like those ratchet type shows like that, Gangland and the Mafia and all of that type of content, man. But I'm caught up in a lot of that stuff, especially on Netflix. They got a lot of that type of stuff on Netflix, man. So I'm all into that. So tune in today My man Poe Politickin talks to Mitchie Slick. All right, the number to the show, you can still call the show old school style, 404-382-0338. You can also email me at Doug at thedougstewartshow.com. So what everybody in America is talking about, not just in sports, because this is kind of one of those issues that crosses over from sports to just, you know, water cooler talk. And it's D'Angelo Russell. So D'Angelo Russell, a couple of days back, found it funny to videotape a conversation between him and his teammate, Nick Young, where obviously it seemed like D'Angelo Russell, we're talking about the rookie point guard out of Ohio State, it seemed like, you know, D'Angelo Russell felt that this whole thing would have been funny to pick, you know, questions from Nick Young, you know, about his love life and about who he's messing with, who he's screwing, who he's boning and all of that stuff. And so, Nick Young, they're discussing this. They're in a private setting. There's no one else around. Nick Young divulges, a.k.a. Swaggy P, he divulges some information about these women or whatever. And somehow or another, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show, somehow or another, this thing becomes public. This videotape becomes public. And at the end of the videotape, D'Angelo Russell says something about, I got you on tape or whatever. But then it cuts off. And then the next thing you know, this thing is all over the world. It's all over the interweb. So, which brings the question is, why? Why would he do this? Now, the back part of the story is, Nick Young is engaged to be married to the R&B young lady. What's her name? I don't know. For some reason, damn, her name just escaped my memory just now. Iggy Azalea. He's engaged to be married to Iggy Azalea. Now, obviously, you know, these women that he's asking about had to have occurred, and the conversation had to have occurred between the time that Nick Young and Iggy Azalea became engaged, because if not, this wouldn't have been a big thing. You understand? If he were talking about all his sexual exploits in the time before he met Iggy Azalea, this wouldn't be a big thing at all. But evidently, that's not the case. So it just came out, and this actually happened a couple of days ago. This story actually came out a couple of days ago, but it came out yesterday in a story on the Puppet Factory, which is ESPN for you new listeners, that basically his teammates are now icing him out. Kind of like what Isaiah Thomas tried to do to Michael Jordan, you know, in the All-Star game back in the day. They're kind of like shrugging the guy off. No one wants to come and eat lunch with him. No one wants to talk to him. And thus, they had the 48-point loss a couple of nights ago to the Utah Jazz. And so everybody's basically assuming that because of this personal inside-the-locker-room issue is why the Lakers got their ass dusted to that degree. The whole thing is bad, bad, bad. Now, when we get back from the break, there's a couple of different angles I want to attack this thing. And you know what? I mean, clearly, this is bad for D'Angelo Russell. And there's a lot to talk about. I mean, there's a lot of opinions to give out. But there truly is a man law. There truly is a man law. And I think this might be the number one man law of all times. And D'Angelo Russell is, in effect, just pissed all over it. The number one man law of all times. So I'll talk about it, man. I'll give you my thoughts on it a little bit more in detail when we get back from the break. What are your thoughts, man? 404-382-0338. You can also email me at Doug at thedougstewartshow.com. One thing we do, I mentioned the chat room earlier. We read a lot of chat here on this show. It kind of makes this show the most interactive show in the world. Okay, so I'll read some of your chat, get some of your thoughts on that. We got a couple other things popping off today. I'll tell you about that. We've got a great guest coming on later as well, right here on the Doug Stewart Show. So don't go away. We'll be back in 3 minutes. This is the Doug Stewart Show. What is ID life? Well, Over the last 18 years, a group of scientists and doctors have been working on the development of a one-of-a-kind nutritional supplement program that takes all the guesswork out of what you need and delivers your truly personalized pharmaceutical-grade nutrition with your name on it directly to your door. Through the integration of thousands of medical and scientific studies, answers you provide to the free assessment and more than 5,470 algorithms that process the data, ID Nutrition recommends what you need, leaves out what you don't, and blocks things known to the system that have possible adverse effects based on the answers you provide. The result is a program that is revolutionizing the health and wellness industry. Welcome to ID Life. For more information, just go to thedougstewartshow.idlife.com. That's thedougstewartshow.idlife.com. Do you have your own radio show? Are you an artist or a DJ? BV Mobile Apps is the solution for you. They specialize in creating mobile apps for entertainers. That's right. You can have your own mobile app where your followers can hear your shows or music, watch your videos, and view all your social networks in one place. You can even make money with banner ads and send push notifications directly to your audience to make sure they get your messages. Everyone has their phones on them, right? A mobile app will add credibility to your brand because your content will be accessible to them while they're on the go. BV Mobile Apps also makes apps for bloggers, actors, and producers. The process only takes about 20 minutes. Just go to bvmobileapps.com and click Get Started Now. That's bvmobileapps.com and tell them the Doug Stewart Show sent you.
At Ticket Liquidator, we believe you should have access to the experiences you want to be a part of. Since 2003, Ticket Liquidator has been connecting buyers and sellers with the most sought-after and often sold-out events across the country. Ticket Liquidator's nationwide network gives you access to one of the largest online inventories of sports, theater, and concert tickets with prices lower than most companies in other markets. And our security policies are solid, so you can buy with absolute confidence. More tickets, better service, and lower prices. So you can witness the best entertainment, culture, and sports events worldwide. At Ticket Liquidator, we know that seeing a legend bring down the house or watching your team win the championship is about more than a ticket. It's about being there. For all your sports and entertainment ticket needs, call us at 855-638-3034. Again, that's 855-638-3034.
Sip the juice. I got enough to go around, and the thought takes place uptown.
Welcome back to the Doug Stewart Show. Wild Out Wednesday. The number to the show is 404-382-0338. You can also email me at Doug@thedougstewartshow.com. But once again, the easy way to be totally interactive is just hit me up in the chat room on Spreaker.com. Pass the word. Pass the gospel of the Doug Stewart Show. Tell at least one person, man. You tell one person today, man, we can rule the world. We can rule the world, Pinky. Yeah, tell one person about the Doug Stewart Show. We really would appreciate it. So this D'Angelo Russell thing, man, is crazy. Big talking point, and this kind of fits in line with what we do around here on the Doug Stewart Show. You know, we aren't all the way politically correct like a lot of other places in media. You know, this is a dude show. This is a guy show. It's a guy talk show. That's what we kind of build it as. And so this fits perfectly in what we do here on a daily basis. My man, D'Angelo Russell, I think broke the number one man law of all time. And that's basically snitching on your boy about, you know, whatever dirt it may be. Now, and I know there's a lot of discussion in the chat room this morning, the Two Live Shoes chat room, and there were a couple of contrarians in the room, and these cats were saying that in this situation that Nick Young is really at fault. And come on, man. I really don't believe, and after reading a couple of these comments, man, I really don't believe that you could be that naive to try to turn the whole story around on Nick Young. If Nick Young was cutting out on his old lady, that's bad. But this story has nothing to do with Swaggy P. It has nothing to do with Swaggy P. And even ESPN, as lame and as politically correct as they are, they didn't even try to perpetrate or portray it like that as well. This isn't about Nick Young. He may be wrong. He's definitely wrong based on what he said, especially if he's, you know, had these relationships with these girls, you know, in between the time where he got engaged and now. But that's not even the story. And if you don't get that, then you're totally lost. If you don't get that, you clearly don't understand man law. You don't. Now, whether Nick Young is wrong or not, that's a totally separate discussion. And you can say, yeah, he's wrong. You can have that discussion, but this involves a dude telling on his friend. Not only that, it's even more. And I saw the, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. Here it is right here. My man Clay Evil Ass is Good Davis. He says, Kobe snitching was heard by secondhand, while Russell is the firsthand dude to snitch. And inevitably, when this type of conversation comes up, I'm sure a lot of the listeners of the Doug Stewart Show is like, Doug, you defend Kobe all the time of what happened when he told the police on Shaq. The thing with Kobe and Shaq is 100% different than this. Not 100%. They're kind of like in the same ballpark. They're kind of like related. They're like cousins or whatever. But what happened with Kobe and the whole story with Kobe is he got pulled over, okay, and he told the police. Oh, no, he didn't get pulled over. They asked him and questioned him about this sexual assault or whatever. And in that conversation, he told the police, you know, flippantly, casually, you know, Shaquille O'Neal, Shaq, his teammate, whenever there's issues like this, he just pays his women off or that type of thing. So Kobe said that to the police, never thinking in a million years, even as young as he was, that the police would go to the newspapers or the police, who are supposed to be admirable, who are supposed to be held to a higher level. He never thought in a million years the police would go out and spill and leak this information. He never thought that. And I don't want to sound like, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show, what Kobe did was wrong. What Kobe did was bad. It was horrible, okay? It was terrible. I'm not trying to, you know, bump for Kobe Bryant or anything like that about that whole man law situation. But this is so, so much worse. Like, I can't understand, and I've been trying to figure out a scenario, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. I've been trying to figure out a scenario where Nick Young thought that this could be, or that this was funny. Like even though he's young and, you know, and dumb and full of, you know what? Like, I'm trying to figure out a scenario in which he thought, D'Angelo Russell thought, that this was hee-hee funny. Like, I'm going to leak this on social media, and there's still even question about whether he leaked it or, you know, did he show somebody, did he email it to somebody or by mistake, and they actually posted or whatever. Whatever it is, taping your boy doing something that would be considered dirt, You know, being the moral police or not in this conversation is wrong. I mean, it's horribly wrong. And I don't know, even though he's 19 years old and clearly he's not very mature. And you remember Byron Scott, the head coach of the team earlier this year, made a comment that D'Angelo Russell's 19, but really he acts like he's 14. And you remember all of the conversation about, you know, Byron Scott not doing these young players right, not doing D'Angelo Russell right. Now you get it. Now it's incredible. Now you get it. And even me as a Laker fan continue to say to myself, why doesn't Byron Scott play this kid more? You know, he's the first pick in the draft. He's clearly the future of the organization. He can play, but why is Byron Scott seemingly mad at this dude? Why is Byron Scott seemingly, you know, have something against this dude? Now you get it. This kid is not there. He's not even to the point maturity-wise where he even understands the severity of the scenario. He can't even understand how big of a deal this is. Evidently, if he put this video out or if he emailed this video to somebody, that means he can't even conceptualize how big of a deal this is for a dude about to get married, you know? He can't even conceptualize that. So how is it that if he can't figure that out, I would, if I were Byron Scott, have an issue with this guy running my team on the floor as a point guard. You know, one's sports and one's real life, but they're very comparable in relative terms. A leader, a team guy. You know, the Kobe thing was bad, but the Kobe thing was, once again, outside of the scope of the locker room to a degree. This was straight up man for man, D'Angelo Russell talking to his teammate, okay? Kobe, once again, never thought that Shaquille O'Neal, his name would come out in anything, and the police obviously, you know, leaked the information some kind of way. We probably don't even know how, but this is so bad, man. And going forward, I don't know how. His teammates are already icing him out right now. I don't know how he can stay with the Lakers going forward if he's going to play with these other guys. Unless they're going to trade all the other members of the team, D'Angelo Russell can't stay in L.A. And not only that, when he leaves L.A., when he's traded to another team or whatever, those teammates on that team are going to look at dudes sideways. They are. Like, I wouldn't want to be, you know, I guess I could be a professional and play with him, but there's a lot more than being a good team, usually, than just what you do on the floor. It's about chemistry. It's about relationships. It's about synergy. And he might get traded to, let's just say, the Denver Nuggets. But if he gets traded to the Denver Nuggets, we can play together. But I really don't trust you. I really don't want to hang out with you. That's probably going to make you feel some way. You're going to feel self-conscious because dudes are questioning you as a dude from now on. This is going to be a huge problem for this guy forever. Forever. I mean, forever. And I kind of feel sorry for him because I do really believe he's just that naive. He's just that gullible. He's just that simple, as my mother used to say. Don't be so simple. Evidently, he is that simple. And it's going to be tough. And it's a hard pill to swallow as a 19-year-old learning this type of lesson that's all over the news and the media is running with it, that's going to probably follow you for the rest of your NBA career. Not even your NBA career. It's probably going to follow him after his career is over in the NBA, because when he's Joe Schmo everyday guy, even the dudes that he quote-unquote hangs out with are going to be very, very cautious when they talk around him. And that's real. That's real. Yeah, I mean, that's real. Because, and we've all had situations where, you know, and I got a particular situation in mind right now that happened to me my freshman year of college. Maybe I'll tell y'all about it when we get back from the break. But we've all had occasions where you said something, maybe not to this degree, but you said something kind of in confidence, and then somebody went back and told the world about it. He's like, dude, I didn't mean for you to tell everybody that. I didn't. And you should have known I didn't mean for you to tell everybody that. This is bad, man. This is horrible. And once again, it continues with the theme of the Lakers are a mess right now. First of all, you have to question the pick at all, the fact that they took him over Jahlil Okafor. And now you add this onto the equation as well. You're talking about Steve Nash. You're talking about Dwight Howard. You're talking about Kobe's bum contract. You're talking about Mike D'Antoni. The Lakers, and I'm a Laker fan. If you're new to the Doug Stewart Show, I'm a Laker fan. I think I said that earlier, but this really hurts, man. And I'm laughing so I don't cry. All right, when we get back from the break, man, I'm going to read some of y'all chat, get some of y'all thoughts on this, man. Wild Out Wednesday. This is the Doug Stewart Show.
Winning huge cash prizes every day at DraftKings.com, America's favorite place to play daily fantasy sports. Daily fantasy means no season-long commitments. Play whenever you want. Just pick your sport and draft your team. It's like a new season every time you play, so you're never stuck with the same players. Last year, $300 million were won at DraftKings.com, and you could be next to win big. Go to DraftKings.com now and enter promo code STEW to play for free. That's STEW for free entry now at DraftKings.com. Also, if you use promo code STEW, DraftKings will match your initial deposit up to $600. Deposit $600, play with $1,200. DraftKings.com, promo code STEW.
Do you have your own radio show? Are you an artist or a DJ? BB Mobile Apps is the solution for you. They specialize in creating mobile apps for entertainers. That's right. You can have your own mobile app where your followers can hear your shows or music, watch your videos, and view all your social networks in one place. You can even make money with banner ads and send push notifications directly to your audience to make sure they get your messages. Everyone has their phones on them, right? A mobile app will add credibility to your brand because your content will be accessible to them while they're on the go. BB Mobile Apps also makes apps for bloggers, actors, and producers. The process only takes about 20 minutes. Just go to bbmobileapps.com and click Get Started Now. That's bbmobileapps.com and tell them the Doug Stewart Show sent you. Protect yourself at all times. The referee issues that reminder because it's important to a fighter's safety and success. Doug Stewart here to tell you about the team at Strickland Security and remind you that living in the Metro Atlanta area is sometimes like boxing. You've got to protect yourself at all times. There's nothing more important than ensuring the safety of your family and your home. And for business owners, protecting your business is critical because it's your livelihood. Strickland Security can satisfy all of your security needs. The staff at Strickland Security has a combined 55 years of experience protecting people and property. From alarm systems to uniformed security guards and everything in between, Strickland Security has an affordable solution for you. To see a list of all the security services they offer, visit their website at StricklandSecurity.com or give them a call at 800-422-9075. Again, that's StricklandSecurity.com or give them a call at 800-422-9075. Welcome back to the Doug Stewart Show. I'm seriously scratching my head over here, man. And you are listening to the Doug Stewart Show. This D'Angelo Russell thing, man, is a mystery to me because I just can't believe. I can't believe somebody that made enough on their SAT to get into Ohio State. would think that taping his friend, his teammate and friend, I'm going to assume they're going to be their friends. And put it out on social media for the world to see. 404-382-0338. You can also email me at Doug at thedougstewartshow.com. I mentioned at 12 p.m. today the Kicking It with Kesey show, as well as 1 p.m. today, the Poll Politicking show right here on SME. So while you're at your desk, just hang around and check out quality programming right here on the Stewart Media and Entertainment Network. And oh, yeah. A couple of days ago, somebody, I don't know why it even came out, but somebody says, man, well, you should have Pinc Gator on. And Pinc Gator is the rapper that has the outro track on the Doug Stewart Show, I'm a Q. So my man Pinc Gator is going to come on today, man. We're going to talk to him for a minute. P-I-N-C Gator. We've been using that track to get out of the show for probably like the last 4 or 5 months, maybe even a little bit longer than that. And I don't know why I didn't even think to have him on because he's a very talented artist, man. Really doing big things. So, frat as well. So, we're going to have my man Pinc Gator on today at the very end of the show around 11:50 Eastern Time right here on SME. So this is 1988, my freshman year of college, Newberry College, and my roommate, and I don't even know if I should call his name. Yeah, I'm going to go ahead and call his name, Tony Lomax.
For anybody that played with me at Newberry College, any of my friends at Newberry College, y'all remember Lomax. We used to call him Lomax. So Lomax, this good guy, I mean a great guy. He's from a little small town in upstate South Carolina. I'm not going to give that name. And, you know, real great guy. So we're freshmen. I mean, we're a couple of months into, you know, our freshman year. And, I mean, I score real big time with, like, the baddest chick on campus. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. And all this is tied into this D'Angelo Russell thing. So I scored with this chick, man, and I'm a freshman, and I think this chick was a junior. She had to be at least a junior. But she was fine as frog hairs. I mean, just real, real fine. So after I do, man, I go back to the room, and I, you know, I'm really breaking a man law, I guess, to a degree. No, I'm not really breaking a man law with this. I'm breaking kind of like a woman law, you know? I'm not breaking a man law, technically. I go back to the room, man, and I'm excited. And I tell my boy about this, and he's grinning, and he's laughing. Did you knock it out the box, Stu? He's real country. I was like, man, I absolutely wore that out. And I think no more about it. The very next day, we go into the cafeteria. We're sitting there at the cafeteria, man, eating lunch. This chick walks by, and as soon as he sees her, he raises up his head, and he says, Stu told me he knocked it out of the box last night. Like, I couldn't even say, man, what are you talking about? I couldn't even, like, respond to him. I immediately looked at her and was like, what is he? And she just looked at me with such disdain. And she just wanted to just cut right through me. He just wanted to cut right through me. And listen, I didn't make that big of a deal of it because this was my boy. And I know he was country as all outdoors. And he just didn't understand. He just didn't get it. And it's with my girlfriend, so it wasn't that big of a deal in relative terms in comparison to this story. But it was bad. And the point of that story is, from that day on, we became very good friends. Real cool. We still cool to this day. He came to my wedding. But after that day, I never, ever said one thing around this dude that I didn't want to get out. Much less of a situation than this whole D'Angelo Russell Swaggy P thing. But the point of that story is to let you know is after that, I didn't have any more trust in telling this guy anything important. I would tell him casual things, you know, things that really didn't matter at all. But I limited it to that. And I was 19 years old. I was 18 years old. And so, you know, Swaggy P has got a whole much more on the line. This story is national now. My story was just talked about around the campus, a small campus at that, around the locker room. Dudes was laughing at me. You know, Lomax went out and put your business out there like that. And this chick is mad with you now. Now all the other chicks on campus going to be mad at you, which wasn't the case. It was all right. They didn't care. You know? So I guess I broke a woman law, and I kind of kissed and tell, and no kind of about it, I did. And I normally don't do anything like that. But this chick was so fine, I had to tell somebody. Yes, sir. Hell, man. But you should have seen the look. I wish that I had, like, a photo of my face when dude screamed that out. Stu told me he rolled your side out last night. Sound like Johnny Cash. Oh, man, it was so bad, man. So this D'Angelo Russell thing, I don't know how he's going to live this down. And it's real. And I see a lot of people in here commenting still about the whole Shaquille O'Neal and Kobe Bryant thing. And, you know, how that still follows Kobe today. As much as I guess I'm on the side of, you know, trying to downplay the whole Kobe Shaq thing, I get it. I totally get why dudes won't let it go. That probably happened, what, 10, 11, 12, 13 years ago? And dudes, to this day, this is a great example of how big of a deal this is and how big of a man law it is.
Dudes today will not let Kobe Bryant live that down. Much different circumstances, okay, than this here. Much different. But still today, if you ask anybody, if you ask my brother, he's still killing Kobe Bryant about this. And this happened almost 15 years ago. Can you imagine how this thing is going to follow D'Angelo Russell for the rest of his life? I mean, for the rest of his life. Let me read some of your chat messages here in the chat room. Thank you so much. Y'all got a little kick out of that story. From the OK Sigma, the Lomax fiasco is the real reason Doug left Newberry. No, it wasn't. It wasn't. I told y'all that story before why I left Newberry College, right? Me and the head coach, David Bennett, we didn't get along. We didn't see eye to eye. He wasn't the head coach, actually. He was my running back coach. He was my position coach. And we didn't see eye to eye. And if you want to know who David Bennett is, most of y'all know this story. David Bennett's the guy. He was the head coach a couple of years ago at Coastal Carolina University. Excuse me. And he had that sound bite where he came on, and I don't remember what the scenario was, but he was like, be a dog. We need you to be a dog. That guy. You know, they played that clip on ESPN for a couple of days and talking about his team and his players. He wanted them to be tougher. He wanted them to be like dogs and not like kittens. You remember that whole thing? It was a big, you know, it was one of those big things. And that was my position coach when I was in college. And you can tell based on that comment and the way that he talked that me and him weren't going to see eye to eye on a lot of things. Come on, Dougie. Come on, Dougie. I'm going to need you to come on down. I'm going to need you to hold on to that ball, Dougie. Man, shut up your country ass. From Jesse in his truck. A dude did me like that at work some years ago. Yeah, yeah. Now, and there's a lot of guys, man, and this happens a lot of times in life. You think you know people, you think that everybody lives by the same code that you do, but there's a couple of people that don't. There's a couple of people, and just like these cats in the Two Live Stews chat room this morning, there were a couple of contrarians on there. Like 95% of the people in talking about this were like, you know, on point with, you know, D'Angelo Russell is totally wrong. You know, and as bad as Nick Young may be in the eyes of the public, you know, that's a totally different conversation. But there was like three people in there, you know, trying to make this about Nick Young and his infidelity. You know, I guess you could call that technically because, you know, they aren't married now. But I guess in this regard, you can. And they tried to make it about Nick Young. And so those are the type dudes that when you tell them a story about how you knock somebody's box, they tell him the next day in the lunchroom. Yeah. Like, everybody didn't grow up like you. Everybody don't, you know, get, which is really inherent, I thought. Everybody doesn't get guy code. Everybody doesn't understand the whole thing about snitching. You know, some dudes grow up in different backgrounds and different environments, man. And, you know, they're a little bit sheltered when they're kids or whatever. And their parents have this morality, you know, stance on everything. And, you know, not that there's nothing wrong with being moral. I'm not saying that at all. But, I mean, come on, dude. Seriously? Like, you don't understand the problem with this? Once again, man, I kind of feel bad for the youngin. Because he ain't never going to let us down. Like, the only way, I tell you what, when we get back from the break, I'm going to read more of your chat. I'm going to tell you the only possible way he can salvage this situation even a little bit. I mean, he's not going to ever be able to salvage it totally, but I'm going to tell you what he needs to do to salvage it a little bit. I mean, a little bit. When we get back from the break, and I'll read more of your chat as well. We also got to talk about, man, the Warriors. They get it done last night. They're well on their way to passing the Bulls' 72-win season. We'll get into that up next as well. Kicking it with Kesey coming up a little bit later, man. The Pope Politicking Show. 12 p.m., 1 p.m. Eastern Time, right here on SME. All right, don't go away. The Doug Stewart Show.
Fantasy sports fans are winning huge cash prizes every day at DraftKings.com. America's favorite place to play daily fantasy sports. Daily fantasy means no season-long commitments. Play whenever you want. Just pick your sport and draft your team. It's like a new season every time you play, so you're never stuck with the same players. Last year, $300 million were won at DraftKings.com, and you could be next to win big. Go to DraftKings.com now and enter promo code STEW to play for free. That's STEW for free entry now at DraftKings.com. Also, if you use promo code STEW, DraftKings will match your initial deposit up to $600. Deposit $600, play with $1,200. DraftKings.com, promo code STEW.
Do you have your own radio show? Are you an artist or a DJ? BB Mobile Apps is the solution for you. They specialize in creating mobile apps for entertainers. That's right. You can have your own mobile app where your followers can hear your shows or music, watch your videos, and view all your social networks in one place. You can even make money with banner ads and send push notifications directly to your audience to make sure they get your messages. Everyone has their phones on them, right? A mobile app will add credibility to your brand because your content will be accessible to them while they're on the go. BB Mobile Apps also makes apps for bloggers, actors, and producers. The process only takes about 20 minutes. Just go to bbmobileapps.com and click Get Started Now. That's bbmobileapps.com and tell them the Doug Stewart Show sent you. This is your folk, Doug Stewart. Want to protect you and your family from life's unexpected mishaps? Then join 7. Join 7 is a prepaid legal company under the umbrella of the Protection Group. Join 7 is the only group benefit or motor club in the U.S. that offers auto reimbursement coverage, key replacement coverage, roadside assistance, gives you a current Medi-File, prescription savings, and fully encompassed prepaid legal benefits that include identity theft. They got you back. The average combined cost to purchase these benefits individually is over $850 a year. Join today and take advantage of all 7 for $17 a month. They've been around for over 20 years, so check them out by clicking on the banner link on my page, thedougstewartshow.com, or the app. Just go ahead and join 7. Welcome back to the Doug Stewart Show. I like that track, Waterhead. That's old school right there. Is that Sybil? All right. That's 1989 right there as well, I believe. I believe that was my freshman year in college at my freshman year at South Carolina State. After I had to leave Newberry. Hey, man, the number to the show is 404-382-0338. You can also email me at Doug@thedougstewartshow.com. The Golden State Warriors, they get it done last night, beating the Washington Wizards. I watched a lot of this game last night, man. John Wall kind of struggled last night shooting. I think he only had 8 points. But Golden State wins 102-94. Your boy Steph Curry knocked down 6 more three-pointers to increase his record total on the way to 26 points. And the Warriors beat the Wizards once again. Klay Thompson had 16 points as prior to two games before last night, he had scored over 40 points. Curry, excuse me, and Klay Thompson already have the most combined three-pointers by a pair by teammates in the season. And Steph Curry, the first player in NBA history with 300 threes in a season, has 8 games left to chase 400. Thompson is aiming to top Curry's previous record of 286 threes. They're balling right now, man. I don't know why the studio audience is booing. There we go, studio audience. I mean, as critical as I am of the defense played on Golden State and how I can't figure out how Steph Curry does what he does, they're fun to watch, man. And last night, I watched, man, they really tried to guard him close. And he's just so smart getting off of screens, his ball handling, man. He puts cats on their on skates. So he drives hard, and then he can stop on a dime. And while they're backing up trying to stay in front of him, he just stops on a dime and just shoots it in a millisecond. And nothing but the bottom of the net, man. And I don't know, man. I'm getting more to the point where I believe what I'm seeing. I'm starting to believe what I'm seeing might be actually what I'm watching, you know, and that this just isn't going to be a, a 1 or 2 year thing that he can sustain this for his career. It's just incredible, man. And another thing that bothers me, though, is last night I also witnessed several times where he beat the coverage or beat the defense and got into the paint, man, and they just continue to just part like the Red Sea and let him make layups. Like you have to just knock him on his ass, man. You have to put something in his mind like, dude, when you come in here, we're going to knock you in your ass. You shouldn't come in the paint. But teams just allow him to get to the basket. That's a major difference between now and quote-unquote back in the day. Like, it seems like everybody just moves to the side and lets him get an unattested layup. You can't do that. But they continue to do it. So, I don't know, man. Ball award to the Golden State Warriors. They're at 67 wins right now, I believe. So, all they need is 5 more wins to tie the Bulls. And they need 6 more to pass the Bulls. I think they're going to do it, man. I really think they're going to do it. I mean, ball award to them. I mean, what more can I say? Jesus. Let me read some of your chat here, man, in the chat room. This whole D'Angelo Russell thing, man. Yeah, this whole story and the whole narrative about Byron Scott not feeling these young players, in particular D'Angelo Russell, why would you not put him in the game? And it's about maturity. It's about maturity. And now you get it. Now you totally get it. You know, the issues. You know, Byron Scott's old school. Byron Scott played on the Showtime Lakers. Byron Scott has been around the NBA forever and ever and ever. And it probably just appalled him of the behavior and the attitude and the maturity of this kid early on when he started coaching him. And he made the statement. I said it earlier. Byron Scott made a statement this year that, you know, he's 19 years old, but he really acts like he's 14. That's a very profound statement. You know, a coach wouldn't just casually say something like that if there wasn't more to the story, if there wasn't some substance to the story or to the statement. And now I get it, man, and it actually hurts being a Laker fan. From that ninja, he says, I made that mistake in seventh grade. Stupid. I guess he's talking about telling a friend something and they went out and they blabbed it out, like the story I told earlier. That's why I don't talk about Ish now. I don't put my business out there. You know, social media today is so big. I use social media probably 80% of the time or 75% of the time that I use social media is to promote the Doug Stewart Show and to promote, you know, my business interests or to promote the Two Live Stews or whatever. That's what I use it for. But even I... You know, and I think most people are this way. You don't put your real business out on social media. You know, social media is a phenomenon in itself. And I always, when social media first started, I remember saying to my mother or telling my mother about Facebook. And she was like, and this is the response you get from a lot of the older generation that didn't grow up around social media. Her response was, you put your business out there for people to read? Right. Like, she didn't even understand that. I can only imagine what my father would have said about social media. You put your personal business out where the world can read it? Like, that's unbelievable to the older generation. But social media is so big today. Like I kind of resisted jumping into social media for a short period of time when I first heard about it. And I guess when the first time... I heard about Facebook or whatever. I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to put it on my social media. But you, in effect, you have to. You almost have to be part of social media today in some form or fashion. Now, it always amazes me when I see somebody post something on Facebook or on Twitter talking about something personal. Like, really? You put that business out there for the world to consume? I don't get that at all. But I'm with you, Ninja, man. It's crazy to me, man, and personal things that you don't want people. If you want to keep a secret, you, in effect, got to keep it to yourself. You can't tell one person, and that one person might be your boy. If it's something that you really don't want to get out, you can't tell anybody. From Cornelia Small, I would have just told her that you were so fine, I had to tell my one and only roommate. And I think I did say something, the story I told earlier. I think I did say something to that effect. Man, I was so happy to get with you. I was just happy. And remember, I'm a youngin' now. You know, I'm fresh out of high school. I still got milk around my mouth. This chick's a junior. I mean, she's bad. She about to, you know, go out into the world on her own, graduate college and all of this stuff. And so I said something to the effect of, man, I'm sorry. I apologize. I didn't think he would go and tell everybody like that. I didn't think he was that big of a mouth. I apologize. Can I get it again one more time, though? From Get With It Sports Media. What up, Get With It Sports Media? It looks like a new chatter in the chat room. He says, D'Angelo probably still asking, what did he do wrong? I think he probably at this point understands with all the hoopla, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. But yeah, for someone to do what D'Angelo Russell did, he just didn't get it. Kind of like the story with my boy. He really, truly, it was honest. It was an honest mistake. It wasn't even a mistake in his mind. You know, he didn't think what he was doing, for whatever reason, wherever he comes from, maybe they do that every day. Maybe they don't keep secrets. Maybe they don't tell their boys something like that and expect them to hold it. There's a disconnect. There's a disconnect. Usually when somebody does something like that, there's a disconnect. They don't even realize what they're doing and how bad it is. From 9-0 the Wino, he says LeBron wants it both ways. He wants to be the GM and coach, but doesn't want to take the heat when things fall apart. I've been talking about LeBron last night, this story out about LeBron coaching the Cavs last night, who gave a game away. I watched a lot of that. I was kind of flipping back and forth. Well, that was actually the first game. I watched that game last night. The Rockets were down by like 15 points midway through the fourth quarter. And somehow I turned back and saw the final score, and they lost the damn game last night. LeBron didn't play. But still, it's crazy. From Run Don't Tell Iggy CNC, I can't wait to see the Cavs lose to the Heat in the playoffs. Bron out here trying to be GM, coach, and player. Kyrie ain't hearing none of that right now. Talked about Kyrie Irving yesterday a little bit and the fact that this guy really is an alpha dog. And, you know, it's probably a lot of tension in that locker room. From What Up Falcons, two of my best friends did that ish to me, Doug. Oh, yeah. Yeah, yeah. It takes that happening to you where you tell a friend something in confidence and them telling the world or them telling the person that you told, you know, not to say anything to. It takes that happening to you once or twice before you understand discretion. It does. And I think that's kind of like part of growing up. Like, we've all had that kind of scenario happen at one point or another in your life where you realize that something that you truly don't want to get out, you can't tell anybody. You know, it takes that. It's kind of like hard hand makes soft behind. It's like you a three-year-old kid putting your hand on a stove. You'll do it one time, but you damn sure won't do it twice. And that's usually what happens, man, when you're a youngin', is you put your stuff out there, man, thinking that somebody's going to keep it, you know, you boys or whatnot, and then sure enough, you ass out. Oh boy. It's funny now because it. Let's see. 1988. Let me do the math. This is 1988, 98, 2008, 2018. So that was 28 years ago, if my math serves me correct, and I'm not good at math. That was 28 years ago. I remember like it was yesterday. How my heart just dropped in my drawers. Like my heart just dropped like an elevator drop. Like it dropped straight from my chest into my drawers. Well, I had to go and doo-doo afterwards. When that dude screamed that out. Oh, man. And when he said it, he had a big-ass smile on his face. You know, a big-ass country grinning and shucking smile. Like, damn, bro, are you serious? I'm saying to myself in my head, like, this ninja really did this. He really did this. But it was all good, though. I had to stop your boy. Yes, sir. Sowing wild oats. Yes, sir. Hey, don't go away. We get back from the break, man. It will be hour number two of the Doug Stewart Show. And the latest on John Bones Jones. I'm going to read more of your chat as well in the second hour of the show. Don't forget, at the top of the 12 p.m. hour, man, the Kicking It with Keisha Show. And at 1 p.m., poll politicking. Don't go away. Hour number two coming up next.
At Ticket Liquidator, we believe you should have access to the experiences you want to be a part of. Since 2003, Ticket Liquidator has been connecting buyers and sellers with the most sought-after and often sold-out events across the country. Ticket Liquidator's nationwide network gives you access to one of the largest online inventories of sports, theater, and concert tickets, with prices lower than most companies in other markets. And our security policies are solid, so you can buy with absolute confidence. More tickets, better service, and lower prices, so you can witness the best entertainment, culture, and sports events worldwide. At Ticket Liquidator, we know that seeing a legend bring down the house or watching your team win the championship is about more than a ticket. It's about being there. For all your sports and entertainment ticket needs, call us at 855-638-3034. Again, that's 855-638-3034.
San Jose sports fans are winning huge cash prizes every day at DraftKings.com, America's favorite place to play daily fantasy sports. Daily fantasy means no season-long commitments. Play whenever you want. Just pick your sport and draft your team. It's like a new season every time you play, so you're never stuck with the same players. Last year, $300 million were won at DraftKings.com, and you could be next to win big. Go to DraftKings.com now and enter promo code STU to play for free. That's STU for free entry now at DraftKings.com. Also, if you use promo code STU, DraftKings will match your initial deposit up to $600. Deposit $600, play with $1,200. DraftKings.com, promo code STU. This is your folk, Doug Stewart. Want to protect you and your family from life's unexpected mishaps? Then join 7. Join 7 is a prepaid legal company under the umbrella of the Protection Group. Join 7 is the only group benefit or motor club in the U.S. that offers auto reimbursement coverage, key replacement coverage, roadside assistance, gives you a current Medi-File, prescription savings, and fully encompassed prepaid legal benefits that include identity theft. They got you back. The average combined cost to purchase these benefits individually is over $850 a year. Join today and take advantage of all 7 for $17 a month. They've been around for over 20 years, so check them out by clicking on the banner link on my page, thedougstewartshow.com, or the app. Just go ahead and join 7. Hour number two of the Doug Stewart Show, baby. Yes, sir. Welcome back to the Doug Stewart Show. I just thought of something else about that damn story. And the Doug Stewart Show is brought to you by ID Life. What is ID Life? ID Life is individualized nutrition. Find out more about ID Life. Go to thedougstewartshow.idlife.com. And also, man, do you know about the Triple F campaign, man? It stands for $5 for the flavor. Yes, sir. If you are entertained, if you feel like that the Doug Stewart Show is the best sports and guy talk show in America, in the world, you have a good time around here Monday through Friday for 2 hours, go to thedougstewartshow.com. Donate $5 just one time a month. We really would appreciate it. Help with our goal to taking over the world, Pinky. All right, so that's $5. Go to thedougstewartshow.com. Donate button is through PayPal. It's very safe and secure, and we really would appreciate it. Just one time a month, we really would appreciate it. So, another little part to that story, I guess a little side part to that story is,
Newberry College, for the story I told in the first hour about the chick that I had relations with, and I went back to the room and told my boy. Newberry College, once again, I'm going to guess 90% of the black dudes that were there, they all played football or basketball. Okay, so it's a very small school. It's a Lutheran school. The Lutheran religion is who owns the school, I believe. And so I'm gonna guess that on the entire student body, there were probably 30 black women on campus. That's not a lie. That's how small the school is, and that's how non-black the school was. There were probably 30 chicks on the campus. And so when I told you this chick was bad, she was probably, if you ranked them as far as fineness, she was top 3 out of like 30 chicks, all right? And this chick was super, super fine. And I remember after I did the do, man, I couldn't wait to get back to my damn room. I was damn walking fast. I was fast walking back to the damn room. To blab. I was so damn happy because, you know, I'm a freshman. I just came out of high school. And there's a bunch of other upperclassmen on the football team. And I think we went and I think we told everybody else in the hall, too. So in some manner or whatever, man, the senior and junior players on the team, man, they got wind of this. And he's like, you hit that? I'm like, yeah, I got game. Hello? And so everybody was amazed. So it was a big thing. And like when the whole thing happened in the cafeteria, man, it got like all over campus. And chicks was looking at me side eye truly for a couple of days. But it was only a couple of days. It was all right. Yes, sir. It was all right. But yeah, I learned a lesson, man. I learned a valuable, valuable lesson. I mean, you shouldn't kiss and tell anyway, but I was young, dumb, and full of you-know-what or whatever, and I felt good about myself. You know, that was literally a proverbial pat on my back. Like, yeah, all right, so my monk's going to game, works in college too. Yes, sir. And so it was bad. It was bad for a couple of days. Every time I went, and, you know, it's a tight-knit community. Obviously, if I'm talking about 40 black women and every dude on campus that was black, played sports, you can tell the tight-knit community. So, yeah, for a couple of days, man, chicks was, like, looking at me like, ooh, you so childish, I ain't never gonna give you none. And then they did a couple weeks later. Let me read some of this chat here in the chat room, man. 404-382-0338 is the number to the show. You can also email me at Doug at thedougstewartshow.com. From Coop, it was going to get out anyway. Yeah, maybe. Is he talking about me or is he talking about the D'Angelo Russell thing? From Clay, evil ass is good, Davis. Doug, you snitched on yourself. Yeah, I did snitch on myself. Chico the Alpha, snitching ass, Doug. Yeah, I did. I mean, I was young. From Mocabella, my story is more comparable to Kobe Bryant's story than D'Angelo Russell's story. I mean, there was no ill will in what I did. I didn't, you know, my boy didn't. And this is one reason why I really wasn't that mad at him after the fact, is my boy didn't, like, have a recorder and tape me, you know, a cassette player back then. He didn't have a cassette player and tape me and went out and publicized it all over campus. And that's probably the best comparison I can make to this D'Angelo Russell story. It was nothing like that. It was in effect, it was innocent. He was just young and gullible and, you know, real simple and country as hell. I tell people all the time, I'm from the country, but I ain't country. And my boy was from the country, and he was very country. I told a story before a couple of times. I went home with this dude one weekend, man. And when I got there, like, everybody was talking like, you know, like this was in the 1960s or something like that. Or the 1950s, some little small town. And, you know, and I'm from a small town. But, I mean, damn, don't sound like everybody sounded just from Beverly Hills or something like that, the Beverly Hillbillies, you know? And so, you got to be careful. From Uncle Mike, I may be late, but Stephen A. just slaughtered Russell on First Take. Ooh, yeah, I can imagine. From Loose Neck Lakers Snitch Side, and I'm actually surprised to hear that.
I don't know what's going on with Stephen A. Smith lately, man. From Uncle Mike, I may be late. Oh, no, I'm sorry. From 9-0 the Wino, T-Lou better get LeBron right. Just a bad look to have LeBron out there ordering players. Yeah, he's probably going to have another talk with him. LeBron James, if you don't know the story, LeBron James looked like he was coaching the damn team last night. He had the eyes and ears of his teammates more so than seemingly the head coach, Tyronn Lue. It's not a good look at all, man. From Run, Don't Tell Iggy CNC. RC, that's the problem. And only time he won is in Miami when Riley wasn't hearing that ish. So y'all think that LeBron's got a discipline issue? You think LeBron's got a ego problem where he doesn't want to listen to anybody, where he doesn't want to take coaching? He's uncoachable? Is that what you're saying the problem is right now? From that ninja, Stephen A. can't say ish about anybody. Yeah! Let's move on. I don't want to even talk about Stephen A. Smith, man. From Clay Evil Ass is good, Davis. Doug, is your boy from the One Street Light Town country? Yes. That's exactly the type of place where he's from. And listen, I don't want it to get back to him and like I'm clowning his town. I've always, even when we were roommates, I was like, damn, man, you country as hell. And he kind of embraced it. Okay, so if you're from South Carolina, you'll get this. But the upper part of South Carolina, like near Greenwood, even like, you know, in the other part of the upstate, like the state is separated between, they call it upstate and they call it low country. So I'm from the low country near Charleston. And the upstate, like what I would consider like Greenwood, you know, Spartanburg and all of that area, Gaffney, South Carolina, all upstate, like they have a real country twang about themselves that when I first got to college, I had never really heard before because I didn't, you know, travel, you know, outside of the state of, or outside of the low country to the upstate or whatever. So this is a new experience for me. I'm meeting people from the other part of the state, and to a man, they all had a real country twang. On the other hand, they're cracking on me because I had this real Geechee accent at the time, which, trust me, it was thick. They used to call me Geechee Stew. And they're laughing at me, but I'm laughing at them. Like, ooh, boy, you Geechee Stew. I'm like, man, you country as hell. You sound like you're from the Beverly Hillbillies. You a Clampett or something like that. And so we used to have these discussions when we were roommates, and I used to always crack on him talking about his country accent. And we used to go back and forth on each other. So it's not like I'm dissing him. I'm not saying he's not a great person or, you know, his town isn't a town filled with a bunch of great people. But that's kind of like part of the story to get an understanding of the whole thing. From Chuchi, us just taste okay. I'm working from home today. My kids are riding me, so I'm frustrated as all get out. You can't listen to the show, bro. I know. Put them damn kids to sleep. From Kaza, Doug calling somebody country is like he went to PS23 in the Bronx. Y'all understand what I'm saying. From Loose Neck, Lakers snitch side, you still do, Doug. If you're talking about the whole Geechee accent. The Geechee accent comes out in me every time or times when I get kind of when I get excited, and that's what people tell me. When you get excited, I can hear that Geechee come out of you. But I just trust me on this. If you think I still have some tendencies to come out with that Geechee/Gullah accent, you probably wouldn't have been able to understand me back in 1988. You know, you wouldn't have been able to understand me. Like for the first couple of weeks when I was on campus, the first time I spoke to somebody new, they always had that confused look on their face like, what? What did you just say? Say that again? Yeah. Yeah. The accent was super thick back in the day. I didn't realize it, you know. And I guess technically I still don't get it. I still don't understand what the big deal was about. But everybody was calling me Geechee Stew my freshman year of college. Yeah. All right, when we get back from the break, man, a little bit of entertainment news. I'll continue to read your chat, man. We got birthdays. Fun on the Doug Stewart Show. Don't go away. What is ID life? Well,
Over the last 18 years, a group of scientists and doctors have been working on the development of a one-of-a-kind nutritional supplement program that takes all the guesswork out of what you need and delivers your truly personalized pharmaceutical-grade nutrition with your name on it directly to your door. Through the integration of thousands of medical and scientific studies, answers you provide to the free assessment and more than 5,470 algorithms that process the data, ID Nutrition recommends what you need, leaves out what you don't, and blocks things known to the system to have possible adverse effects based on the answers you provide. The result is a program that is revolutionizing the health and wellness industry. Welcome to ID Life. For more information, just go to thedougstewartshow.idlife.com. That's thedougstewartshow.idlife.com. Do you have your own radio show? Are you an artist or a DJ? BV Mobile Apps is the solution for you. They specialize in creating mobile apps for entertainers. That's right. You can have your own mobile app where your followers can hear your shows or music, watch your videos, and view all your social networks in one place. You can even make money with banner ads and send push notifications directly to your audience to make sure they get your messages. Everyone has their phones on them, right? A mobile app will add credibility to your brand because your content will be accessible to them while they're on the go. BV Mobile Apps also makes apps for bloggers, actors, and producers. The process only takes about 20 minutes. Just go to bvmobileapps.com and click Get Started Now. That's bvmobileapps.com and tell them the Doug Stewart Show sent you.
At Ticket Liquidator, we believe you should have access to the experiences you want to be a part of. Since 2003, Ticket Liquidator has been connecting buyers and sellers with the most sought-after and often sold-out events across the country. Ticket Liquidator's nationwide network gives you access to one of the largest online inventories of sports, theater, and concert tickets, with prices lower than most companies in other markets. And our security policies are solid, so you can buy with absolute confidence. More tickets, better service, and lower prices, so you can witness the best entertainment, culture, and sports events worldwide. At Ticket Liquidator, we know that seeing a legend bring down the house or watching your team win the championship is about more than a ticket. It's about being there. For all your sports and entertainment ticket needs, call us at 855-638-3034. Again, that's 855-638-3034.
Welcome back to the Doug Stewart Show. Wild Out Wednesday. And it's March 30th, 2016. Thank you for joining your boy. Don't forget, at 12 noon today, the Kicking It with Kesey show returns to Stewart Media and Entertainment. And then at 1 p.m. Eastern, the Poe Politicking Show. My man Poe is talking to Mitchie Slick, San Diego, legendary rapper, man. So stay tuned today to the Poe Politicking Show as well, 1 p.m. Eastern time. Some entertainment news, birthdays. Celebrating his 28th birthday today is Richard Sherman, defensive back for the Seattle Seahawks, baller. Happy birthday to him. I actually interviewed him very early in the Doug Stewart Show. I'm thinking back in late 2014. Maybe we'll pull up that audio and, you know, replay that interview at some point here soon. Also celebrating his 54th birthday today, man, MC Hammer. Please, Hammer, don't hurt him. Yes, sir. Please, Hammer, don't hurt him. 54 years old. You talk about have it going on? I mean, speaking of Newberry College, I think the first time I heard MC Hammer was when I was a freshman at Newberry College. As a matter of fact, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show, I think the first time I heard it wasn't even on campus. It was visiting my boy's hometown for the weekend. Like, they were playing it in his hometown that I just was talking about earlier. And he was like, man, you never heard of MC Hammer? I was like, I don't know the hell no damn MC Hammer is. Man, you late, Doug. You damn geeches down there don't know nothing about music. And the rest is history. The great MC Hammer was on the scene. But he's 54 years old today. Happy birthday to him. Tracy Chapman turns 52 years old today. Happy birthday to her. What was that song she had? She had like that one song, plays the guitar, back in the day as well. I don't even remember. Was that Fast Cars or was that another chick singing, playing a guitar? I don't know. But Tracy Chapman, y'all know who I'm talking about. She's 52 years old today. Happy birthday to her. And also, man, in entertainment, tonight is back. The season premiere of Empire tonight. Yes. Yeah. I can't wait to see what's on tap. Lucius Lyons and them folks, man. The Lyons, Cookie and all of them. Back tonight, 9 p.m. Eastern Time, 8 p.m. Central on Fox. Yeah, so there you have it, a little bit of entertainment news. You can also email me at Doug at thedougstewartshow.com. I guess this kind of fits into to entertainment to a degree, but rapper Lil Wayne has signed former Florida State linebacker Reggie Northrup to be the first NFL prospect the rapper's Young Money Sports will market. That's right. Lil Wayne posted an Instagram picture with Northrup before Florida State's Pro Day Tuesday, and Northrup told the Tallahassee Democrat that Young Money Sports will handle his marketing and branding. Okay? And see, I remember when Master P had the No Limit Records label and he signed Ricky Williams, they made a big thing about it, you know. The fact that this rap label and this rap impresario is out here representing athletes, and how dare Ricky Williams sign Master P. Master P and Lil Wayne, they're not going to be in no GM's office negotiating contract. They're not going to be negotiating numbers or anything like that. So just stop it. This is about marketing and branding. I mean, why would you not want to align yourself with Jay-Z, with Roc Nation, and Lil Wayne with this new venture, or Master P and No Limit Records at the time when Master P was on top? Why would you not want to align yourself with their marketing machine? Clearly, they know about marketing. You know, clearly, they have big brands. And so when you cross-promote each other, you know, so maybe at the end of the day, this means like a commercial for the guy, you know, maybe a billboard, maybe a spirit sponsor or something like that, Hennessy or something like that. I got nothing but positive things to say about this, man. Congratulations to Lil Wayne for doing big things. Just stop it. From Vince Wright. He says, all this geeky talk is new for us Minnesota Stewies. Yeah, it's a real strong dialect from people from the low country of South Carolina. It's actually an African dialect. And so it's kind of, it kind of sounds like island, you know, an island tone to it, like Jamaica or the Bahamas or something like that. You have to hear it, man. From Demetria 2000, as a Savannah Geechee, I was culture shocked in the big city ATL. Country, love the A though. And he's exactly right. I mentioned earlier how the upstate of South Carolina, they sound real country. But in the low country, we have this quote unquote Geechee accent. And same thing. The Savannah is kind of like part of the low country as well. They call Savannah, which is at the bottom of Georgia, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show, they call that the low country as well. So, you know, there's a lot of the Geechee accent in that area as well. And, yeah, when you come to Atlanta, you think Atlanta City. But the minute you talk to one person from Decatur, when the minute you talk to a young person, more in particular, if you talk to one young person from Decatur, you can tell that they have a very strong accent as well. It's very country sounding as well. It's a different kind of country sounding than upstate South Carolina, but it's still country in itself. Yeah, he's exactly right. And the Geechee accent, man, and I hate to even try to just jump into talking about, you know, trying to talk like I'm back at the crib or whatever, because it's kind of like a natural thing.
But the Geechee accent is kind of like, well, you listening to the Doug Stewart Show right now, the number one sports talk show in America. And if you say it ain't the number one sports talk show, I box you in your eye. I box you dead in your eye. Who for say the Doug Stewart Show ain't the best show on radio? It's the best show. And if you say it ain't the best show, I knock you in your eye.
And that might be exaggerated to a degree, but that's it. Yes, sir. That's it right there. That's it right there. That's it for right there. From corporate brother. Whoa, Doug. I'm from Decatur, shawty. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. You from Decatur. You know what I'm talking about. He just put shawty on the end of it. Yeah, you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. So a lot of times I'll title an episode of the show something shawty. So when I first moved to Atlanta, I actually was part of a company, kind of like an independent record label. Everybody was trying to be a, you know, puffy bag during that time. And we had this group from Decatur. When I tell you, and these were young boys, they were like 17, 18, 19 years old, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. So this little rap group from Decatur. When I tell you, every single sentence that came out of their mouth at the end of it, no matter what they were trying to say, no matter whether the sentence would fill with verbs or nouns or adjectives or whatever, at the end of every single sentence, they put the word shawty. As in S-H-A-W-T-Y. Shawty! Okay? All right? And so, trust me on this. They have their own country-type accent here in Atlanta. They're from the city. You know, Atlanta's the city. But Atlanta has also got some country talking people, man. Don't get it twisted. Yeah. So, yeah. 404-382. And I love Atlanta. I always talk about how much I love Atlanta. But, yeah, when I got here, too, I found their accent, their country accent, very, very, very strange. You know, you have the procession of Atlanta. This is this big city. This ain't the Bronx, like somebody said earlier. This ain't Brooklyn or Queens. It's city, but it's a different kind of city. It's a southern city, have you? From JT008, people get country twisted with slow. Big mistake, partner. Right. And I guess you could say that. It's a slow drawl, kind of like that I've noticed with people in Atlanta, Metro Atlanta. And they'll kind of draw, they'll kind of like drag their words or whatever. From K3000, Philly Rocket Today, what up, Rail? From Clay Evil Ass is good, Davis. My dad's side of the family is from the east side of Louisiana, while my mom's side is from the west side of the state. Okay, he's talking about different dialects even in the state of Louisiana. From Mo Cheeks for three, Doug, you hit on the nose. I lived in Chucktown for 7 years. I boxed you in your eye. That's kind of like a Chucktown term, a low country term as well. Let's see, from Loose Neck Lakers Snitch Side, Doug's accent sounds like a cross between Red Stripe and Nigerian cab driver. Yeah. And once again, I mean, the Geechee accent comes from the western part of Africa. I could teach a history class here about why we talk the way we talk in the low country and all of that stuff in the dialects, man. 404-382-0338. You can also email me at Doug@thedougstewartshow.com. When we get back from the break, man, the latest on John Bones Jones and that whole traffic stop thingy that he got involved with yesterday, you don't want to miss that. Stay tuned to that, and I'll continue to read your chat. And we kind of stopped talking about it, man, but if you got any thoughts about D'Angelo Russell, man, I mean, I'll talk about it some more. I mean, it's just, like, I guess I'm not saying anything much more than what a lot of you are thinking about the D'Angelo Russell situation. If you could, if there's somebody out there that kind of feels like that what he did wasn't that bad and that we're making too much of it, and give me a scenario on why it's not that bad, and give me a scenario on how his teammates now and going forward are going to be able to coexist with this dude. Because I just don't see it. I just don't see it. More sports talk with Hot Sauce coming up. The Doug Stewart Show. We'll be right back.
At Ticket Liquidator, we believe you should have access to the experiences you want to be a part of. Since 2003, Ticket Liquidator has been connecting buyers and sellers with the most sought-after and often sold-out events across the country. Ticket Liquidator's nationwide network gives you access to one of the largest online inventories of sports, theater, and concert tickets, with prices lower than most companies in other markets. And our security policies are solid, so you can buy with absolute confidence. More tickets, better service, and lower prices, so you can witness the best entertainment, culture, and sports events worldwide. At Ticket Liquidator, we know that seeing a legend bring down the house or watching your team win the championship is about more than a ticket. It's about being there. For all your sports and entertainment ticket needs, call us at 855-638-3034. Again, that's 855-638-3034.
Fantasy sports fans are winning huge cash prizes every day at DraftKings.com, America's favorite place to play daily fantasy sports. Daily fantasy means no season-long commitments. Play whenever you want. Just pick your sport and draft your team. It's like a new season every time you play, so you're never stuck with the same players. Last year, $300 million were won at DraftKings.com, and you could be next to win big. Go to DraftKings.com now and enter promo code STEW to play for free. That's STEW for free entry now at DraftKings.com. Also, if you use promo code STEW, DraftKings will match your initial deposit up to $600. Deposit $600, play with $1,200. DraftKings.com, promo code STEW. This is your folk, Doug Stewart. Want to protect you and your family from life's unexpected mishaps? Then join 7. Join 7 is a prepaid legal company under the umbrella of the Protection Group. Join 7 is the only group benefit or motor club in the U.S. that offers auto reimbursement coverage, key replacement coverage, roadside assistance, gives you a current Medi-File, prescription savings, and fully encompassed prepaid legal benefits that include identity theft. They got you back. The average combined cost to purchase these benefits individually is over $850 a year. Join today and take advantage of all 7 for $17 a month. They've been around for over 20 years, so check them out by clicking on the banner link on my page, thedougstewartshow.com, or the app. Just go ahead and join 7. Welcome back to the Doug Stewart Show. And thank you so much for tuning in. The Doug Stewart Show is brought to you by ID Life. Go to thedougstewartshow.idlife.com. Take the free assessment and get your health and wellness together in 2016. In about 15 minutes, man, we're going to talk to the man, the myth, the legend, Frat Pinc Gator, man, going to come on and talk about his career. The outro track to the Doug Stewart Show, I'm a Q, was done by my man Pinc Gator, man. He's been at the game for a long, long time. So before we get out of here today, we'll wrap with my man Pinc Gator, so stay tuned for that. Told you the story yesterday about John Bones Jones getting arrested for drag racing. UFC former light heavyweight champion John Jones was arrested and booked into an Albuquerque, New Mexico detention center Tuesday for violating probation. Jones, 28, was processed in the Bernillo Detention Center at about 10 a.m. local time. According to facility records, he's currently serving an 18-month supervised probation sentence, which was part of the plea agreement he signed in September, stemming from a felony charge for leaving the scene of an accident. And if you don't know the story, he got stopped by the police, and the police's explanation on why they stopped him was because he revved his engine at a stoplight. No, you heard me correctly. If you're new to the Doug Stewart Show, we talked about this yesterday. Not that he was actually drag racing or that he was exceeding the speed limit. He was at a stoplight, foot on the brake, and he punched the gas. For whatever reason he did it, I don't know. He claims that there was a fan of his in the car to his left, to his immediate left, and he was kind of like acknowledging the person by revving his engine. I don't get that. Maybe that's how they do it in Albuquerque. I don't know.
But that's his reasoning. But he was not speeding. And, oh, man, you can go out and find the video of the cop. He had the body cam on, man, and he just basically was trying to – he was trying to instigate He was trying to instigate, you know, where they basically bumped heads and trying to incite John Bones Jones to do something. John Bones Jones is MMA champion, once again suspended in the UFC. And it was a bad look, man. And it just reminds you, man, a lot of times, even with, you know, these body cameras, man, a lot of times that's how it is when you get stopped by the police, man. They don't have good intentions. You know, for whatever reason, they don't like you. They don't like the way you look. They don't like the way you talk. They don't like where you're from or something they don't like about you, you know, and they make it personal. And if you watch this video, it was totally personal. The dude was clearly trying to get under John Bones Jones' skin. It was bad, man. And even though he knew this thing was being videotaped, he still came towards dude like this or came at dude like this. Can you imagine how many times that same type of scenario played out and it turned into something worse? You understand where I'm going with this, where it turned into something worse and we didn't have the body camera, we didn't have the video footage and how the police came and spun the story. Can you imagine? We actually can witness what you said and the way that you said it and you still are the police. You still are in the right in a lot of people's eyes in this country. I mean, it's bogus, man. His attorney feels very confident, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. His attorney, John Bones Jones's attorney, feels confident that no rational judge will feel like that he violated his probation by, you know, this citation. You can't be reasonable, and I guess maybe in some type of way it's in the books as far as their laws are written down there in that part of New Mexico in that town, but you can't rationally say this man violated his probation because he was at a stoplight and he revved his engine too much for your liking. You can't. I mean, seriously. So I'm going to keep my eyes on this story, man. I hope that's not the case. I hope this isn't a setup because it does seem like a setup. Dude's had traffic issues or driving issues and the police somehow pull him over because he's revving his engine too much. Sounds like a setup to me. 404-382-0338. Let me read some of your chat here. From, let's see, we got, oh, my man, K3000. What up, K3000? He's wrote a book here. K3000 is the actual writer for the Doug Stewart Show. He says, ATL kill with the A-A-A-A-A. 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 Y'all got rappers in all states saying it. Laugh like-ish every time I hear rappers. Oh, you talking about, you can find me in the A, the A, the A, the A. Yeah, okay, I got you. After a slick verse, these fools don't know what they're saying. That's the problem. Have rappers with today. They don't do their homework. How you going to finish your rhyme and say, A, 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 you ain't from the A, 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 A. So he's saying that a lot of rappers not from Atlanta even throw that in their rhymes because they had no even clue where that even came from. From that ninja, they don't give a damn about those cameras. It's all good when you know what you won't be held accountable. Yeah. From Cornelius Small, probation is usually a setup. And talking about the whole John Bones Jones situation. From Peter Quill, the only thing they could have got him for was a noise violation. Yeah, yeah. And you can imagine he's probably in a super nice car. And they probably, if he's in a little town in New Mexico, you can't tell me every single police officer in that town doesn't know which car John Bones Jones is driving. You see what I'm saying? Just like in any small town, you know who's got, there's not a surplus of $100,000 cars driving around in a small town, in small town USA. So every police in that town probably knew his car, and you pull him over for some crap like that? That's what I'm talking about, man. That's what I'm talking about. Your experience with the police might be a lot different from mine, man. You know, just remember that. When you talk about, oh, so-and-so, they talking back to the police. No. Your experience with the police is a lot different than mine and a lot of other people. Let's be honest about it. Thanks for calling the Doug Stewart Show. What's your name? Where you calling from? What you want to talk about?
Doug Stewart, what's happening?
What's up? Who's this?
Steve from Huntsville, sir.
Steve from Huntsville! What up, baby?
And enjoying the tickets through hours in sports, man. You know, as I've stated many times, you know, when I came on your show, I don't listen to mainstream radio for a multitude of reasons. So I hadn't heard the story, you know, and I hadn't been, you know, off on social media. So I'm just now getting wind of it.
Right.
So when you brought it up, my first thought was, okay, here comes some kind of minor story they're trying to make a big deal out of. So I'm all set and ready to defend, you know, Russell, who's a Buckeye. And then you let that story go, and I'm like, damn.
You know what I'm
saying? Right. Much as I want to defend them, I really can't. But I was checking the man law book, and I think I might have an explanation.
Okay.
It states clearly in the man law book, page 1, paragraph C, line 7. You shall not repeat what your brother has told you in confidence. This is to include and not to end or exclude verbal communication, dry snitching, sign language, Morse code, social media, and or any and all recording devices.
Right.
So there's absolutely no doubt that he did violate this law.
Yes.
Okay, that's understood. But there's a provision.
Okay.
And the provision states, if said man that violated this law has friends or family that is subject to the threat of violence or death, exceptions can be made.
So to summarize, unless your life is on the line, unless somebody has a gun to your head and like, you need to tell me what so-and-so said, then, you know, you can't violate this law. That's the only scenario in which you can get away with this, if you're about to lose your life.
That's pretty much it. Now, it's also for your immediate friends and or family being under the threat. So, I mean, obviously, somebody, you know, much like in the movie Taken, kidnapped Russell's family or somebody close to him.
Damn, T just dropped. I didn't even do that, T. I think we got the gist of your call, though. This is the Doug Stewart Show. Yeah, and you've seen that type of scenario many times, play itself out many times on movies where somebody's like being held captive and they're trying to get some information out of the person. Under that scenario, when somebody has a double barrel shotgun up to your head and they're like, you need to tell me this information or you're going to die, and which usually in that situation, you're probably still going to die anyway, so you probably just need to keep it to yourself. Outside of that situation, you don't do what D'Angelo Russell did. You just don't do what he did. I mean, outside of that remote scenario, that remote setup, you can't do what D'Angelo Russell did, man. Like, your mama's going to die if you don't tell us this, or your daddy going to die, or your little brother going to die if you don't tell us this information. If you don't tell us what Swaggy P said to you about his sexual exploits with other women outside of Iggy Azalea, we're going to kill you. Unless that happened, he's dead ass wrong. Yes, sir. All right, we get back from the break, man. We're going to talk to my man Pinc Gator, and we'll wrap up today's show. Don't go away. This is the Doug Stewart Show. Radio show? Are you an artist or a DJ? BB Mobile Apps is the solution for you. They specialize in creating mobile apps for entertainers. That's right. You can have your own mobile app where your followers can hear your shows or music, watch your videos, and view all your social networks in one place. You can even make money with banner ads and send push notifications directly to your audience to make sure they get your messages. Everyone has their phones on them, right? A mobile app will add credibility to your brand because your content will be accessible to them while they're on the go. BV Mobile Apps also makes apps for bloggers, actors, and producers. The process only takes about 20 minutes. Just go to bvmobileapps.com and click Get Started Now. That's bvmobileapps.com and tell them the Doug Stewart Show sent you.
At Ticket Liquidator, we believe you should have access to the experiences you want to be a part of. Since 2003, Ticket Liquidator has been connecting buyers and sellers with the most sought-after and often sold-out events across the country. Ticket Liquidator's nationwide network gives you access to one of the largest online inventories of sports, theater, and concert tickets, with prices lower than most companies in other markets. And our security policies are solid, so you can buy with absolute confidence. More tickets, better service, and lower prices, so you can witness the best entertainment, culture, and sports events worldwide. At Ticket Liquidator, we know that seeing a legend bring down the house or watching your team win the championship is about more than a ticket. It's about being there. For all your sports and entertainment ticket needs, call us at 855-638-3034. Again, that's 855-638-3034.
National Debt Relief is one of the country's largest and most reputable debt settlement companies, made up of energetic individuals who are passionate about helping thousands of Americans with debt relief. Most importantly, we're all about helping our customers through a tough financial time in their lives with education and individual customer service. We're dedicated to helping individuals and families rid their lives of burdensome debt, specializing in debt settlement, and they've also negotiated settlements for thousands of creditor and collection accounts. Providing clients with both expertise and proven results, this means helping customers in time of hardship to get out of debt with the least possible cost. It can also mean conducting financial consultations, educating the customer, and recommending the appropriate solution. Core Services offer debt settlement as an alternative. I repeat, alternative to bankruptcy, credit counseling, and debt consolidation. National Debt Relief is your number one advocate group to help you reestablish financial stability as quickly as possible. So give us a call at 844-828-4975. Again, that's 844-828-4975, and work it out.
Welcome back to the Doug Stewart Show. Wild Al Wednesday. March 30th, 2016. Now listen, don't forget, and I'll probably mention it one more time at least. Coming up at 12 noon Eastern Time, man, the Kicking It with Kesey Show right here on the Stewart Media and Entertainment Network. My man Kesey is going to talk to Jamie Bennett, entrepreneur from Fortune 500 company. To entrepreneur, she's going to talk about success. They're going to talk about success. And then at 1 p.m. Eastern Time, my man Poe from the Poe Politics Show is going to talk with Mitchie Slick, San Diego rapper, veteran. He's going to talk about his life and the hip-hop scene in San Diego. My man Poe always brings the fire with those interviews, so stay tuned for that. But joining me right now on the line is the man, the myth, the legend. My man, Pinc Gator, P-I-N-C Gator. Gator, what's up, brother? How you doing?
And you spelled it right. It's your girl, man, Pinc Gator, P-I-N-C Gator. Man, you spelled it right. My dog.
Yeah, yeah, man. I'm a fan, bro. We actually are in the same fraternity, and I think most of y'all know it. I play the song at the end of the show every day to the people that tune into the show every day, and they hear Pinc Gator, and a lot of them like, who is that guy rapping at? And I'm like, that's my frat right there. Bruh, talk about your career, man. How long have you been in the rap game? Because I think a lot of people think that you just rap for the cues, but you're not new to this. You're true to this.
Thank you, brother. I appreciate you mentioning that. I have consistently been pursuing the music since 2006. Now, I've done plenty of projects with different artists. I've been in the music business since 2006. And as you mentioned, a lot of people just think I did this cue song. No, I am an artist. And even though I publicly have over 130, 140 songs, people still only think I have done Humble Cue.
Yeah.
For some odd reason, but I understand. You know, a lot of people fall in love with what they heard first, and they keep it there a lot of times.
Now, not taken away from the I'm a Cue track that I play at the end of my show every day and all of the music and the love that you show to the bros. I mean, that's really helped propel your career and kind of make you like a household name nationally, is all of the love that you've shown Omega Sci-Fi Fraternity and the music that you put out, right?
Yeah, it is globally. helped internationally also. And I'll be honest, you know, the first one I did, you put it out, I was confident. I knew it would, you know, it hit, you know, fraternally and even externally. But, you know, I kind of did not realize the significance of what the song was doing. The song was really, I learned later on, years later on, that the song was allowing me to grasp the ears of many people, young, older, whatever you want to call older. It was allowing me to grasp ears of all ranges of people where you normally would have a lot of gaps at.
Right, right.
And so once I realized that, I began to, basically, I have a platform to a certain extent. And so once I realized the significance of what this song does and what it's doing and what it's still doing and what it did, I began to make sure I cater to my platform and cater to my people and basically strive to be the change that I want to see in this world.
Talking to Pinc Gator right now on the Doug Stewart Show on the Stewart Media and Entertainment Network. Kind of tying into that, I wanted to stop you right there because kind of tying into that, man, is, you know, I pledged Spring 90. You pledge what? 90 what?
No, man, don't do me like that. I'm Spring 02. AW2.
Spring 02? I thought you were in the 90s for some reason. and which is Sam Houston State, right?
Yes, sir. Correct. Sam Houston State. Yep. Kind of tying
to what you were just talking about, man. I never thought in my 26 years of being an Omega in the fraternity that I'd ever come across a song that kind of rivaled, you know, George Clinton's Atomic Dog
right.
song as far as the hype.
Right.
Are you even shocked at the love that you get in comparison to Atomic Dog?
I am shocked. It's overwhelming sometimes. But I think it may have been 2004. I was just riding around about 3, maybe 4 a.m. through Houston. And I was just pondering. I'm an artist. So therefore, whatever your craft, whatever your trade is, I believe it should be your goal to leave a mark in that industry or in that world with your craft. So I was, you know, I'm in the fraternity. Also, and I'm an artist. I'm like, well, self, how can you leave some type of mark within this fraternity and outside of this fraternity? Because tomorrow is not promised, you know. And that's another reason my album, one of my albums called 100 Years From Now, Tomorrow is Not Promised. So you want to leave a legacy. And me being an artist, I'm like, well, it makes sense. Do something for the brothers.
Right, right.
And I came up with the song in my head in 2004. I did not record it until July of 2006.
Right, right.
Yeah, I did not record it until then.
Talking to Pinc Gator right now, finishing up with Pinc Gator on the Doug Stewart Show on the Stewart Media and Entertainment Network. He's the artist that performs the track at the end of my show every single day. I'm a Q. Speaking of George Clinton and Atomic Dog,
yes.
You actually worked with George Clinton,
yes.
or kind of like a
yes.
remix. And then you also,
yes.
I want you to talk about doing the video and having Shaquille
yes.
O'Neal in the video with you.
What, when I initially recorded I'm a Q, when I recorded it, the very first version has a sample of Atomic Dog. So that pretty much tells you where my mind was at when I was recording it. And I'm a Q was actually a freestyle. We did not write that. We just went in the studio. I already had it in my head for years. We just ran with it. Anyways, so, and you know how it is when you roll the Q. We made it up on the spot. I didn't know what I was going to say. Anyway, so I had George Clinton in mind. I had Shaq in mind. But I'm like, this is MySpace days. I'm like, man, that'll never happen. Shaquille O'Neal on the track? Maybe, but George Clinton? That'll never happen. So, anyway, make a long story short, Shaquille O'Neal, he walked into the place of business I used to work at. I did not tell him I was Pinc Gator. I said, you heard him, McHugh. He said, I never heard it. I said, I got this new CD in my car. I'm going to give you one. That was a Thursday. He was at my house that Sunday.
Wow.
I'd never met him in my life. Nothing like that. He had never heard the song. And he was in Houston, like, doing, like, 3 or 4 community service events, and like he was like, I gotta get to this dude, I gotta find this Pinc Gator, whoever he is. And when he came to the house, he fell through the floor, because that was me at work being discreet about what it is I do while I'm at work, giving him my CD.
Right.
And then in 2006, I messaged George Clinton and his people on MySpace, and MySpace at that time had notification to tell you when they read it. Well, they never replied. And so I emailed them in 2008. They never replied. 2010, I'm going through an email that I do not use, highlighting all, delete. And right when I said, let me slow down and stop deleting these messages so quick, it said, reply George Clinton.
Wow.
And they replied to an email at this time that I sent 2 years ago. So all in all, it was 4 years until they replied.
Wow.
Or even acknowledged. They said, hey, you know, we love the song. Matter of fact, we'll be in Houston performing on such and such date. Give us an address and we'll come and record. Because even though George Clinton's in Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, I was confident enough in what I wanted to do, and I actually sent him pretty much sort of like an imitation of what I wanted him to do on my record, and I imitated his voice and sent it to him.
Wow.
And so, anyway, make a long story short, they came to the house, you know, he's like 72, 73-year-old guy, you know, after he just got to perform it.
Wow.
He comes to the house, gout. He comes to the house, man, and I'm telling him again, yo, this is how I want you to sing it. And I'm a little nervous, Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, George Clinton.
Right.
He paused and looked at me. I'm like, uh-oh. He's like, Youngblood, you got a good voice. Sing it with me.
Right.
I said, it's going down.
Wow.
So, yeah, man. And, you know, he dropped a lot of game, man. He spent probably like two hours in my house recording with me. Beans and Cornbread, my producers, they were there too, man. Family was there. I mean, it was an event. To this day, that's the highlight of my music career.
Wow.
From here on, I don't care who I need. I don't care if Tupac comes from the dead. That will always be my highlight.
Yes, sir.
And he just dropped so much game and so much jewels within those 2 hours. I have 2 hours of audio the world has not heard yet.
Right.
Besides what he put on Centennial Remix on the Q.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. Awesome. Yeah. Awesome. Hey, bro, we got to wrap up today's show.
Yep.
Before we let you go, though, I want you to tell my listeners, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show on the Stewart Media and Entertainment Network. Before we go, I want you to tell my listeners where they can find your music at online, and then I want you to introduce your track, I'm a Q, before we get out of here.
Yes. It's your girl, man, Pinc Gator, Pinc Gator, one and only, never leave you lonely. Make sure you go to PincGator.com, or you can go to iTunes, PincGator.com. I don't care what you do, just spell it right. We just finished the album, Welcome to Gatorville, that will be released the next month. So, you know what it is, you tuned in live to the Doug Stewart Show. Hey, next track coming up is I'm a Q. Get with it or get going to get your face bone stepped on. Peace.
Yeah.
You gon' eat your beans and cornbread.
Yes, it's your grown man Gator. Pinc.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. And thank you so much for tuning in to the Doug Stewart Show today. Shout out to my man Pinc Gator for that interview. Yes. You hear it in the background. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Hey, shouts out to all of the Stewies, everybody that tuned into the show today. I really appreciate it. Shouts out to my man Waterhead Walter, Dwayne Vassan, Gerald Oliveri, engineers to the show. If you're new to the Doug Stewart Show, this is how we do it every day. Every single day. All right? So pass the word. I'll be back tomorrow. Same Doug Stewart time, same Doug Stewart channel. Coming up next, as a matter of fact, the Kicking It With Kesey Show right here on the Stewart Media and Entertainment Network. If you follow the show and the network, you should get an alert. If not, if you don't get the alert, that means you need to do something in your settings. But still, my man Kesey's coming up at the top of the hour, all right? Tomorrow, same Doug Stewart time, same Doug Stewart channel. Peace!
Sci-fi till I die, I'm a cute. The comic dog at my wedding, I'm a cute. If I have a little boy, he don't play as cute. I'ma have him in the cut, getting good, I'm a cute. Everybody in the hood know his daddy is a cute. I had to do a song that was trippy for the cute. I'm a cute, I'm a cute. When I was knee high, I dreamed to be a cute. And now I'm 25, damn right, I'm a cute. And a step show one day, I'm a cute. When we get second place, I'm a cute. Break my LB, dust them off, I'm a cute. Drop chicken on the floor, brush it off, I'm a cute. 4 a.m. still out, hanging with the cues, I'm a cute.
I'm a cute. You know how it is when you roll with the Q's. You know how it is when you roll with the Q's. You know how it is when you roll with the Q's. You know how it grown is when you roll with the Yeah. I guess by now y'all can tell I'm a cute. Ain't trying to talk down, just saying I'm a cute. I still got love for the those who ain't cute. Some of my tightest partners ain't no cues. They know one thing for sure, I'm a cute. Duty calls, gotta go, no offense, I'm a cute. And they got my back, stay dying for the cues. I'm a cute. I'm a cute. Mama told me long time ago about them cues. Told me I could go Greek, but don't be a cute. It was in my nature to go and be a no. Even in preschool, mama knew I was a no. Girl asked me my name, I told her I'm a cute. Teacher asked me my name, I told her I'm a cute. Cops phone ID, I tell them I'm a cute. I'm a cute. I'm a cute. You know how it is when you roll with the cues. You know how it is when you roll with the cues. You know how it is when you roll with the cues. Hey, you know it's how your it grown is man when yes, bruhs in the club, don't blow up your hooks. If you ain't a bruh, don't blow up
even
your hooks.
Even if you ain't no cute, respect the big jammin', baby.
If you ain't a bruh, don't blow up your hooks.
Bruhs
in the club, don't blow up your hooks. If you ain't a bruh, don't blow up the hooks. Bruhs in the club, don't blow up your hooks. If you ain't a bruh, don't blow up the hooks. But you know how it is when you roll with the cues. You know how it is when you roll with the cues. You know how it is.